In this video, we will look at the way you can use slide masters and color schemes to create effective PowerPoint templates and layouts. To begin with, if you've got a PowerPoint program that loads up in an old-fashioned sort of aspect ratio, this sort of square-looking slide, you'll need to change that, particularly if you're intending to present your presentation on a widescreen projector, or you're recording your presentation for distribution on something like YouTube, because YouTube's default format is widescreen. To change the layout, go to the Design tab, and then go to Slide Size, and choose Widescreen. Also on the Design tab, there are some themes to choose from. So you can see here in 2016's version of PowerPoint, there's lots of different colourful themes there that you can choose from. You've also got the option within the Design tab to choose a colour scheme. So I'm going to keep my default style and theme, but I'm going to choose a specific colour theme. So here I've got a colour scheme called Blue Warm that comes with PowerPoint. I'm going to choose that for my presentation. I like to have a darker background for my slides and lighter text. So the best way of doing this is actually to change the colour scheme. Go to the Colour Scheme Picker again, and at the bottom choose Customize Colours. Then what I'm going to do is change the dark to light and the light to dark. It's as easy as that. And I'm going to click Save. And there we have now a very dark background. Now black is quite sinister, perhaps too dark for my presentation. So I'm going to change this to a nice blue colour. Simply right click on the slide and choose Format Background. The Format Background pane appears. There are different types of background that you can choose from. You could have a gradient fill and use one of the patterns that's provided. The thing to watch out for with the gradient fill, though, is if you're recording your PowerPoint presentation, normally what will happen is the gradient, although it looks nice and slick and smooth here, nice transition between the light and the dark, when it's recorded and encoded, particularly for YouTube, this gradient will end up looking quite blocky, and you don't get the finer detail of all the different colours available. So I avoid using gradients, and instead just use a solid fill. You can use also a pattern or a picture fill. So let's go to the picture option here now and choose a file from my computer. And I'm going to choose there a nice leaf picture. You can see that with the leaf picture, we have different colours in the background. So we've got some nice dark colours here, which will work well with the light text. But as we move over to the yellow leaf, the text becomes harder to read. There is one way to address this. If you select the text boxes, you can then go to the Format tab and change the shape fill to be a solid colour. You might also choose the More Fill Colours option and just change the transparency. And that allows some of the background to come through, but with the solid colour, allows the text to still stand out from the background. However, for my presentation, I would like a solid fill because I'm going to be using some transitions that work best when we have a plain background. So I'm just going to undo all my changes here, and then from the Format Background pane, I'm just going to choose a colour, which is nice blue colour there. So you can see the white text stands out nice and clearly from the blue background. Once I'm happy with that, I'm going to apply that to all my slides. So I'm going to click Apply to All, and that means that when I create a new slide, that also adopts the same colour scheme. With new slides, you'll end up with a template that has some bullet points. I avoid using bullet points because bullet points encourage you to put more text on the slide than is actually really necessary. If you think about when you're watching a PowerPoint presentation, if it's covered with text, it's very difficult to identify what the key points are. And bullet points end up encouraging you to put too much text on the slide. The layouts that I prefer to use are the plain layout. So if I click the slide and then choose Layout from the Home tab, I can choose a title-only layout or a blank layout. What I want to do is create a new layout. With these layouts, it puts in all the text boxes, all the placeholders for you, so all you need to worry about is adding content. And the layout I want to create is a new number layout that I can use to grab people's attention with a statistic. To create a new layout, I'm going to use Slide Masters. To access Slide Masters, go to the View tab at the top, and then choose Slide Master. The Slide Master presents all the layouts available within your particular template. Click the very top slide on the left-hand side, which is the main master slide, and then choose Insert Layout. You get a new layout that appears at the bottom of the left pane. On your layout, you will see a title placeholder has already been put onto the slide. And the titles are really important because they provide the bookmarking facility for the PowerPoint presentation, and it gives the structure to the presentation. So it's important to keep a title on your slide in one way or another. Even if you're using a blank slide, you can always tuck a title up the top out of the way so it doesn't show. But the title's useful for the bookmarking features within PowerPoint. I've just dragged that to the bottom at the moment because what I want this slide to have is a nice big number here. So to do that, I'm going to do Insert Placeholder and then choose Text. I'm going to drag a nice large box at the top. Immediately, PowerPoint takes you down that slippery slope of using bullet points. So I'm just going to select all that text and delete that, go to the Home tab and remove the bullet points from that box. I'm going to add a couple of hashes in there just so I can see what it's going to look like, and that gives a cue for the placeholder as well. So those hashes will appear as the placeholder text when we use layout for the real slides. I want to increase the font size to a really big size there. I'm also going to bold the text. Now to do that, I'm selecting the frame rather than selecting the text. So I'm just going to make sure that I'm selecting the frame there so it's got a solid line around the frame. Make that bold, and I'm also going to choose an accent color from my palette. So I'm going to choose the blue, the lighter blue there. The title I'm going to use underneath the number, and that's going to provide some context for what that number is actually saying. So I'm going to reduce the text size for the title. I'm also going to align the text to the top of the box. That means that when we've got a number there, the text is quite close to the number, and it'll be consistently the same distance between the number and the title text. So I think that's my slide done now. That's my template done. I'm going to right-click on the slide and rename it to Big Number. And then going to the Slide Master tab, I'm going to close the master view. I can then choose my new layout. So if I go to New Slide, I can choose my Big Number layout. Or if I've got an existing slide, I can change the layout to Big Number. And this will allow me here, for example, just going to put in 99% of slides look awful. And there we are. I have not had to do any text formatting. I've not had to put any placeholders on, extra text boxes. I've used my layout to quickly create that slide. And I can keep creating new slides with that layout using the same layout to create effective designs. So really quickly there, we've got a slide that conveys one point, nicely spaced, quite clear design there, and that's what you can do with slide layouts. If you wanted to save your layout, perhaps you wanted to share your colour scheme and layout with another colleague to work on another set of slides or the same slides, you can save your template as a PowerPoint template. So I'm just going to remove all my slides here. We don't actually need those. We just need one slide on with the colour scheme we want to choose, and go to File, Save As, and choose the POTX PowerPoint template extension. I'm just going to label that my new template and save. You'll be then able to choose that template when you're creating new slides. So if we go to the File menu and New, and I go to My Personal Slides, I've got my new template there to choose from, and immediately I can choose my new layout as well.